Now at 6:30 on WKYT This Morning, police are investigating two suspects after an overnight robbery at a Central Kentucky gas station.
A man wanted in a string of crimes in Southern Kentucky was arrested in Lexington.
And we're looking outside with widespread rain showers. First batch of energy is kind of moving on out. Now we're going to start to see the next batch come on through, and also a little bit of snow in the forecast. We'll go over the latest details coming up.
Also, the list of undefeated teams gets shorter after Duke goes down in an upset.
Tracking, alerting, protecting. This is WKYT This Morning.
Good morning. As good as a win for some Kentucky fans. Good morning, everybody, and welcome in. It's good to have you with us on this Monday as we get this new week off and rolling. I'm Bill Bryant.
And I'm Rebecca Smith. What a game it was against Texas A&M.
Oh, yeah. The Cats hanging in there, but and it was a battle, wasn't it?
It was.
And, of course, we hate to hear about this injury to the women. So we'll keep you updated on all the latest. Let's check in right now with Micah. He's in our First Alert Weather Center. We have some rain here and there.
Yeah, we do, and it's very widespread off to the east and southeast. Then we're taking a bit of a break there in the central zones. And now we'll start to see that next wave of energy come on through as we work our way into the day. Now, here's the deal. Most of us are sitting above 32 degrees there on the roads. I checked the roadway temperatures, except for the northern zones. Northern zones, which there's not much falling out of the sky, and that's good news. But here comes that next batch of energy that's going to be pushing some rain into the northern zones. Heads up, overpasses, bridges. We could see some of those areas right there with some slick spots. Only isolated, it's not widespread, so no major concern. Sitting there with temperatures above freezing for all. Now, 24-hour forecast, we're going through the day. We don't rise that much. By the afternoon, we're sitting there in the upper 30s, lower 40s, and I believe it's right around sunset, maybe a little bit after we start to see the first flakes fly. And look, this isn't going to be much, but this could be enough to really drop down and maybe cause some concerns there on the roadways overnight and into tomorrow morning. We'll really go over the details, what the snow means for you tomorrow morning, getting up, going off to work or school, coming up in just a few minutes.
All right, we'll see you, Micah. Thank you. And here's the latest from WKYT.
New this morning, we are tracking a crime alert after an overnight robbery.
Police in Bourbon County right now questioning two suspects at police headquarters. Dispatchers there say the Shell gas station on Main Street was robbed early this morning. We have a call in to Paris Police. We have not yet heard back from them. We'll let you know what we find out.
Family members are speaking out after a stabbing landed a man in jail and his nephew in the hospital.
The weekend assault happened at a home in Junction City in Boyle County. WKYT's Mark Barber is at UK Hospital this morning where the victim is said to be in a coma. Mark, good morning.
Good morning, Bill and Rebecca. Family members say that Brandon Hobbs was seriously hurt in this violent family fight. They tell us that his uncle stabbed him several times, piercing his aorta. They tell me that they're hoping for a quick recovery, but they say this morning he is here at UK Hospital in a medically induced coma. Brandon Hobbs' uncle, Sean Hobbs, is a man accused of stabbing the 23-year-old. When we spoke with Sean Hobbs' son, he told us his father was attacked too. He says the stabbing was not a random attack. Instead, he claims it was an act of self-defense. We're told Brandon Hobbs and Sean Hobbs were fighting in a Boyle County home on Saturday when the nephew left the home for a while. Family members say when he came back, he tased his 49-year-old uncle up to five times. Family members tell us that's when Sean Hobbs attacked his nephew with a knife.
Probably afraid he was going to die. He already had the knife in his hand, so it's not like he actively went to find it to hurt him.
Is charged with first-degree assault. He's being held on a $50,000 bond in the Boyle County Detention Center. Live in Lexington, Mark Barber, WKYT.
All right, thanks so much, Mark. A woman is in jail this morning accused of stabbing her boyfriend. Nicholasville police say Elizabeth Maston stabbed the man in the chest, face, and arm. She then called 911 and waited for police to show up. Maston is charged with assault. We do not know how the victim is doing this morning.
A fugitive from Laurel County has been arrested in Lexington. State police say Joshua Smith stole vehicles from a car lot last month in Laurel County and used them to then break into a pharmacy. Well, over the weekend, police got a tip that Smith was in Lexington. He was arrested at a hotel in Hamburg. We're tracking a crime alert this morning after a Lexington restaurant was robbed at gunpoint. Police say a man robbed the Dairy Queen off New Circle Road last night. They say he's in his 40s, about 6 feet 3, weighed about 200 pounds or so, and was wearing jeans, a red hoodie, and a black scarf at the time. And police are investigating another robbery at the Shell station right across the street from the Dairy Queen there. Police say a man stole two cartons of cigarettes. A customer followed the suspect outside, who then got into a car, and that's when police say his passenger pointed a gun at the customer.
Secretary of State John Kerry says he will travel to Paris Thursday for talks on countering extremist violence. The announcement comes as the Obama administration faces sharp criticism for not sending a senior official to Sunday's rally for unity in Paris that was attended by some 40 world leaders and more than a million people. Kerry says he's going to reaffirm U.S. solidarity with America's oldest ally, that being France. Divers in the Java Sea have located Air Asia Flight 8501's cockpit voice recorder, but it's still lodged beneath heavy wreckage more than 100 feet deep in that sea. Divers have retrieved the plane's flight data recorder, which they found under a piece of the aircraft's wing. The U.S. Senate is expected to hold a procedural vote today on the Keystone XL oil pipeline, but the Republican-controlled chamber will have to vote to end a Democratic filibuster before taking up the measure. Last week, the House passed a bill approving construction of the pipeline, which would run through several states and carry oil from Canada to the Gulf of Mexico. President Obama has promised to veto the legislation if it passes Congress.
Our time is 6:36 on WKYT this morning. He has been with the Lexington Police Department for almost three decades, but today Assistant Police Chief Mark Barnard will officially become Chief of Police. The promotion comes at a time when police across the country are coming under more scrutiny. WKYT's Hillary Thornton is live in Lexington this morning, where today's ceremonies will be taking place shortly there at headquarters. Good morning, Hillary.
Good morning, Bill. Mayor Jim Gray appointed the former Assistant Police Chief Mark Barnard last month, and today he will officially become Lexington's top cop. Barnard is a 28-year veteran of the department. He beat out three other candidates for the position. He is taking over for Ronnie Baston, who retired as chief and will become Lexington's Public Safety Commissioner. Mayor Gray calls the new chief a bridge builder with a strong background in community-oriented policing. Barnard says he is both humbled and honored to be named chief.
We sacrifice a lot, and it's emotional because I know how much they want to serve this community and to be representative of the body and soul of these people that sacrifice every day is overwhelming at times, but they deserve the gratitude that they get.
The swearing-in ceremony is set for 9 o'clock this morning here at police headquarters. Live in Lexington, Hillary Thornton, WKYT.
Hillary, thank you. Attorney General Jack Conway will officially file his candidacy for Kentucky governor today. Conway and his running mate, State Representative Sani Overly, will share their vision for how they want to move Kentucky forward. Conway, a Democrat, has served as the Commonwealth's top attorney since 2008. In 2010, he lost a U.S. Senate race to Rand Paul. Overly is currently the Democratic caucus chair in the Kentucky House.
Legislative leaders want to make changes to the state's $9.5 billion budget. They're looking to plug a hole in the state's struggling retirement fund for public school teachers and build a cancer research facility at the University of Kentucky. Democratic House Speaker Greg Stumbo has filed a bill that would borrow up to $3.3 billion to help the Kentucky teachers' retirement system make its monthly benefit payments. A University of Louisville player is suspended after being arrested over the weekend. Redshirt freshman Terrence Ross is charged with felony assault of a probation or police officer. The Courier-Journal reports that police say Ross had marijuana. In a statement, the university said it is aware of the situation and continues to gather new information as it becomes available.
A Kentucky State University freshman is hoping to be one of the few Americans to compete in the 10K race in reclusive North Korea. 18-year-old Duncan Adams, who is a liberal studies major, says he is crowdfunding to raise money for the Pyongyang Marathon in April, despite the heightened tensions between the U.S. and North Korea. It would be the first international experience for Adams. It would also be his first competitive race. Adams says he plans to casually train for the event. Well, it is game day in North Texas. The first college football playoff national championship game matches the second-seeded Ducks and the fourth-seeded Buckeyes tonight at AT&T Stadium. Oregon and Heisman Trophy winner Marcus Mariota are in search of the program's first title. Ohio State is looking for its fifth championship and the first under Coach Urban Meyer. We'll see how that goes. And the Duke Blue Devils, the number two college basketball team in the country, lost Sunday to unranked in-state rival NC State. The score was 87-75. Immediately after the game, Wolfpack fans stormed the court. Duke was one of the three undefeated teams remaining. That leaves only Virginia and, of course, your Kentucky Wildcats. They'll be looking to keep that perfect record intact tomorrow night. Kentucky hosting Missouri for a 9 o'clock tip-off.
Mm-hmm.
Exciting time.
It's going to be an exciting tournament, I think. Let's check to see how traffic is moving this morning.
And let's go to Officer Don with a check on live drive traffic. Hey, Don, good morning.
Hey, good morning, gang. We do have a stalled car. It's inbound Newtown Pike, just past New Circle over in the right lane. So keep that in mind this morning. Just checked inbound Tate's Creek Road. The slowdown there is at the circle, just the left turn lane to the Interloop's backing up. Everyone's slowing down this morning and taking it easy, as they should, with the wet roads. Live look at Broadway and High Street. And on our Waze map, no wrecks popping up. We're okay through the construction zones right now on the circle between Leestown Road over toward Old Frankfort Pike in that area. But we'll keep an eye on that throughout the morning. So please be careful. Now back to you in the studio.
All right, Don, thank you so much. Officer Don in Deanna on 98.1 The Bull when you get in your car. And we're glad you're with us on WKYT this morning, here on your Monday.
The couple here found out the hard way their dog has expensive taste in treats. She actually ate her owner's wedding rings. We'll tell you how much they are worth.
And more things, Mike, the dog ate.
Yeah, that dog eats anything. We saw that this morning. First Alert Defender Live Radar. Taking a bit of a break there in the central zones. Nonetheless, these roadways are still wet because we had this piece of energy roll through and even some slick roadway issues too. And I'll go over the latest forecast, what you can expect the next 24 hours with some snow coming up next.